It is not a change of mindset, it is not a change of thinking, but...
After an impressive seventh finish at FIBA Women's AfroBasket in Kigali, Rwanda, the Gazelles have been welcomed back by the FUBA president, Nasser Serunjiji, at Hotel Africana.
Yes.
The AfroBasket 2023 is done. We've done what we did or what we were able to do. Now it is time to move on to the next campaign, which starts today. And we have a code name, Gazelles AfroBasket Vision 2025. So this goes out to all the players that the planning and the preparations start now. I have already had a discussion with the head coach, who will be in touch with all the players to give you a program, to give you a plan and a roadmap for us to prepare for 2025. So please bear in mind that we need to start, the preparations as early as possible. Gazelles AfroBasket Vision 2025, our target is to make the Final Four.
Being the best the Gazelles have ever attained at the Continental Showpiece, the assistant coach Ali Mavita has urged players to be disciplined so as to develop their career.
Well, it's important to be disciplined. People work hard. I mean, people are very skilled, people are very talented, but on top of that, they're very skilled. On top of that, they're very, very disciplined. So if everybody is skilled in a room, what's going to set you apart? I think it's your discipline, it's your effort, and that's not negotiable. It's really not negotiable. So we have to be able to be disciplined, not just... It's with everything, what a professional player needs, what you eat, what time, how much you rest, how much you work hard, and how much effort you put in. So it's a lot of discipline to get to the next level.
Lydia Babidia reveals that they are now focusing on the FIBA Women's AfroBasket 2025.
See us keep going and working in as many AfroBasketball championships or AfroBasketball tournaments as possible. Maybe 10, 20, whichever one, I don't know, but I'm just going to say that we're going to take it step by step and keep moving forward. As long as we have the team together, we're working together and working on our games, then we'll be able to move forward.
In attendance were the players, including Janan Otoo, who made it to the Women's AfroBasket Team of the Year and won the top scorer award of the tournament with 128 points. Uganda's journey to storm the semifinals of the tournament was halted by the host Rwanda losing 66-61 at the quarterfinals.